your floor.
I'm here. You're here. And you're looking at me. my heart is overjoyed tonight to spend the evening with my family, my wife and children, my school district. Wonderful teachers. Thank you so much, teachers. Can we give our teachers another round of applause? DC, I'm proud of you. And I can't wait to say that in person. Thank you so much. I'm gonna get to it, because I did write something, so. So good evening. It is truly an honor and a blessing to stand before you at this moment in a position that I never could have dreamed possible. The opportunity to represent the amazing professionals in this room and across the state as we lift up students to do great things. The educators, stakeholders here tonight, along with supporters of teaching and learning, hold the key to a brighter future, both globally and nationally, unlocking the inspiration of young scholars who will use their creativity and imagination to be the problem solvers of today and beyond. This has been an immensely challenging year. However, teachers have risen to the occasion and continue to do great things in spite of the circumstances, as evidenced by the many success stories that we heard tonight. My journey is a story that depends on the grace of God, the strength of the village, and the inspiration of teachers. In the late 80s, my family and I settled in North County, St. Louis, coming home to the neighborhood that my father grew up in, Kinloch, Missouri. Kinloch is the oldest African-American community to be incorporated in the state of Missouri, with many of them being black soldiers arriving home from World War I. In the 1920s. The city was once a destination point for African-American families looking to raise their children in a community where they would thrive and be valued. In Kinloch lies legacy for my own family. My great-grandmother, Hattie Stevenson, also affectionately known as Mama Didi, helped to establish the Kinloch Fire Department and stayed involved in her local church and local government. My grandmother, Elizabeth Hutcherson Brooks, taught at the all-black Vernon School in Kinloch and was the first African-American to teach white students once the district was incorporated with the Ferguson-Florissant School District, where I now teach. However, by the time we moved in, things had changed. Over time and circumstance, the city began to diminish. Most businesses had closed or moved away, houses were abandoned, and streets were in disrepair. Being from Kinloch, although cherished by many who still live in the city, became a negative mark to others. Today, the city is in need of restoration, love, and hope, like so many of our students. Teachers have the immense task of helping to inspire learners to see a vision for their future that considers the past, connects with their present, and hopes for their ultimate success. I was a light-skinned mixed kid with off-brand shoes and clothes that didn't always fit, skinny, awkward, and teased in school. My parents did their best to raise my siblings and I, 8 in total, but the saying is true, it takes a village to raise a child. For me, that village included my teachers, gifted guides who can shine a light on the path to potential for their students. I was bused from Kinloch to the far northern part of the school district as part of the desegregation program in my neighborhood. There was often a cultural stigma around being too smart or too studious in my neighborhood. During my sixth grade year at Commons Lane Elementary School, I had the privilege of being in the classroom with Mrs. Wright. She had a way of making me feel special and important despite the negativity I sometimes felt elsewhere. I remember the time I got in trouble in her class. Man, that wasn't often because my dad didn't play. Her disappointment was enough, though, to keep me on the right path because I knew that she really cared. She was a light for me. Teachers and educators were a consistent thread in the narrative of my success. I also remember my high school advisor, Dr. Jim Swearingen. All I wanted to do was graduate, and he insisted that I get the college preparatory certificate. And I also think about Dr. Bill Richardson, my college band director, and my first ever African-American male teacher who helped me to see past my inadequacies that I felt as an aspiring young teacher to a vision that I could be something great. That is the call of an educator, helping students to see the true potential that lies within. I would like to take a moment to give honor to both those who support educators and me personally as we do this preeminent work. Thank you to the organizations that stand with teachers in the work they do every day, NEA, MSTA, AFT. Thank you to Dr. Margie Vanderman for your tireless leadership and work as commissioner. I would like to say thank you to Mr. Charlie Shields and the state and local boards of education for tough and fearless decisions that you have to make to serve our students. Thank you, legislators, administrators across the state. Thank you to Dr. Paul Katnick, Linda Dooling, and Curtis Terry for the work that you do with Educator Quality Program. Linda Dooling, I wish you all the best in your new journey. Governor Mike Parsons, thank you for your attendance tonight and the support of teachers in our state. I would like to give a huge thank you and shout out to my new family, the Missouri State Teachers of the Year, DC, Misty, Darby, Beth, Shelly, and the list goes on. You've been so supportive and so loving toward me, and I appreciate you so much to the bottom of my heart. Thank you to the Regional Teachers of the Year and finalists. In hearing your stories and meeting some of you over these last few weeks, I'm impressed, and I am honored to stand among your ranks. Thank you to Mr. William Shaw and other community partners and sponsors whose generosity promotes and supports the Teacher of the Year program in our state. Thank you so much to the love and support that my family and I receive from our local church communities. Thank you, Jeff Ahrens, for your encouragement and tireless reading of my essays. I would like to say thank you to the local community partners that I've had the privilege to work with. Strings Attached, Suzuki Harmony STL, St. Louis Classical Guitar, and Life Arts, among others. Thank you for the opportunities you give to our youth. I would like to take just a moment and pause and give honor to my wife, Miki Lagyon.
Yes, Miki.
My children, Sasha, Nayora, Enosh, Imuna, Simeon, Naomi, and Elsie, who sacrificed hours away to only get half of me sometimes when I come home from a hard day. Miki Lau, thank you for being a supporter, innovator, inspirer, and love of my life. You are amazing. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yes. Young girl.
Thank you to my mother-in-law, Rose Baker, for your nonstop love and support, and reminding our family to celebrate. I would like to thank and honor Dr. Davis, board members, administrators, everyone here tonight representing and supporting me. You all are awesome. Thank you so much for being here. I would like to give honor to my head principal, Ms. Francois, and my supervising principal, Dr. I. Dr. I told you before, your leadership, your mentorship, your coaching have been invaluable over these last 2 years, and I really appreciate you. I'd like to say thank you to Dr. Jennifer Andrade for being my longtime friend, mentor, former principal. Yeah, I'm putting you on blast. You've helped me grow tremendously, and I love you for it.
I love you, man.
I would also like to honor my former colleague and co-teacher, Judy Brown, who poured every ounce of her heart to the work that she did for students. I've learned so much from working with her, and I'm truly grateful for that time. I would also like to say thank you to my collaborating teaching partner, Carly Moore, for walking with me through the craziness of this year and more to come. I would like to give honor to and a shout out to my entire Johnson Wabash 6th grade center family for all the work that you do to make a difference in the lives of our students and community. I would like to give honor to my mom and dad for being my first principal and superintendent and for teaching me to be responsible, as well as my 7 siblings, for your grace in being my first classroom. Mom, thank you for blueberry muffins, long conversations, and love when I was away in the Army feeling lonely and unsure of my path. Dad, thank you for being my first role model, music legend, and superhero. Thank you to every teacher, mentor, friend, and family member in my journey along the way. Thank you to my students. I learned so much from you. And I would like to give honor to you, all the professionals listening right now, in each capacity that you serve our students. Truth be told, my original plan was not to become a teacher. And I got somebody in the audience right now who can tell you that truth too. I wanted to play music, make records, tour, and become famous, giving a shout out to my teachers when I got that Grammy Award. Fast forward several years though, and I was honored to hear recently a student in my class say that he wanted to be a teacher one day. It is important that we teach students to take their place in the broader community to serve, to give back with a motivation going deeper than just what they can do for themselves and extending to what they can do for others. Teachers, administrators, leaders, community partners, let us persevere, fight the good fight, and don't give up. You are a teacher and you are an inspiration to someone whose future depends on you. Students need someone to believe in them and tell them they can do something great. Whether teaching is in your official title or you're a part of an organization that supports teaching and learning, your work counts. Your work matters. I would like to close with some audience participation or some call and response, so please humor me, okay? My wife's grandmother, Elsie Blackshear, who lived to the age of 99, had a favorite saying. She would say, just keep on keeping on. I'm gonna make some statements, and in response, if you agree or you can relate, I want you to say the phrase, keep on keeping on. All right, so we're gonna practice. Here we go, 3, 2, 1.
Keep on keeping on.
Yes, that's it, all right. All right, so here we go. When you've had your third cup of coffee, but you still feel exhausted, you gotta
keep on keeping on.
All right. When you did your best, but you still don't feel success, you have to
keep on keeping on.
All right. When you have that student that you feel like you just can't reach, you have to
keep on keeping on.
When you bomb that lesson and you have to reteach, you have to
keep on keeping on.
When the world seems upside down and things just don't make sense, you have to
keep on keeping on.
Because somebody depends on you. Thank you for being the village for our Missouri students, and have a wonderful rest of your school year. Thank you.
Get up there, all of you.